Hey guys, it's me Matthew, of course, and in this video I'm playing Warframe, and I would like to apologize for the big ugly bar at the bottom of the screen. I don't like asking people to like, comment, and subscribe, so I'm trying to work on an animation that'll pop up and then come back down. I'm testing this out, and also, you know, actually doing something about it before I forget and then push it off even further. So yeah, I'm gonna have that bar at the bottom of the screen until I get tired of it, or until I make the animation, or have someone else do it for me, because I'm not that good at it, but we'll see. I know how to do like a very simple, I could make that come up and down. I think I'd make it look nicer if it was gonna just, you know, it'd be smaller and more compact if I was animating it. Anyways, that's not the point of this video. Before I get into it though, I would like to mention that I've been streaming Warframe a lot the last couple days. I have been farming on stream Sevagoth, the Epitaph, and I mined and fished for like 3 hours to get all this. Anyone who joins the chat and asks is more than welcome to join me in the game. All I ask is that you don't misbehave, I guess. I don't want to ban anyone, but I will if I have to for the sake of my stream. But, yeah. So I finally am getting my Void Rig. Sevagoth is awesome, and I want that Warframe so bad, and I've heard good things about the Epitaph in 3 more hours. Alright, and I also, oh yeah. I have one Protea helmet going, but I just bought this one with Nightwave stuff. So let's get that one going. Protea Math Helmet. And I apologize for any echoing you might hear. I hope that there's none, but sometimes it gets through. And I don't notice it when I'm going through and editing. And I couldn't help but yawn right there. I have been up way too long. And I shouldn't be recording this video. Took a hike this morning, I streamed for 9 hours, and now it's midnight, and I am recording a video, but I don't know, sometimes things just happen all at once. But I have a to-do list of things, because there's so many things to fucking farm in this game. I have a bunch of Warframes and how to get them, just generalizing things that I need to do. Some of them I have more detail if I can fit it on here. I have Baruch, and it looks like I need Little Duck, and I need to get more standing with Little Duck, and then I need 15,000 standing just to buy the remaining parts of Baruch. And then whatever resources I need to build him. For Zaku, I just need 5 gyromag systems and 2 scintillant, I don't know. Octavia Prime, I need a chassis and the blueprint. And then I have Nausea Prime. I need the blueprint, the neuroptics, and the chassis. So there's a lot going on here. I think I'm gonna start off with some relic farming, because Baruch, you know, I guess I can check Baruch first. I'm gonna go to Fortuna, and of course, room 69, if it's available, you go there, and if you can, you stay there. Why? It's 69. Do I really need a reason? Alright, let's get that cinematic. And I wanted to go to Little Duck. one thing that I've always noticed with this is that this place will, like, not let me leave sometimes. I need to get rid of those wings, I swear. Voxel are standing. I need 22,000 more. I'm gonna need gold toroids, which I don't think are too hard to get. And I have 10 Atmos systems. Trade toroids for standing. So I need to get toroids, which I don't know entirely how you get them, but I have a general idea. I also need to build an amp here at some point, a better one than the one I have. Fox Lara standing browse wares. Yeah, I got the main blueprint. Plaga, I need, yeah, okay, I'm gonna need toroids, hespasm, alloy, solid toroids, and radiant zodion and calda toroids. That's gonna be a lot of fun, I'm sure, farming all that stuff. But I have an idea of what I might be doing tomorrow if we play, or if I play Warframe tomorrow. We might take a break, or I might take a break since it's mostly me playing this. And we might play, like, keep talking and nobody explodes. That is such weird ambience. It almost sounds like it's in real life. I gotta stop there for a second just to make sure there wasn't someone on, like, a megaphone outside or something. Alright. Void fissures. Shut up. And then I immediately yawn. Wonderful. I can't stop myself from yawning. I think Octavia would be probably the easiest. I need to see if I have a Neo Z7 and an Axie O5. So Neo Defense, Axie Exterminate. Let's check out this one. Axie O5. I have one. And I want to upgrade that all the way to Radiant. I think this only gives it a 10% chance to drop. So it's still very low, but it's better than, like, the 2% that it is at normally. I have one of those, so that's good. That's the only one that has the blueprint. I'm going to be yawning a ton, so fair warning. And just for ease, I'm going to go and look for Neo and Z7. I don't have any Neo Z7s. Those I farmed from the Ghoul Bounty. That is the highest chance. I don't know if it's the most efficient. I only wrote down what has the highest drop chance. And that's Ghoul Bounties, which I never do those. For good reason. Let's do this exterminate. And let's take the 05 Radiant and hope I get lucky. If not, I have to farm those on the Lua Disruption mission. But I can also farm the chassis Neo N13 for Naja there. I think they have the same drop chance. Jeez. Alright. I need to probably turn down the audio just a bit, just to avoid echoing. It's already so quiet, but my head is right next to my microphone, and my headphones are open. Open back. So that means that they can be very, they're not good for recording things. If you want to record and you're looking at getting new headphones, as nice as open back headphones are for audio files, get a closed one that won't, you know, a good quality closed one, so it doesn't cause any echoing problems. Alright, I'm just going in circles, what the hell? Why didn't it tell me to go backwards? I guess there's like a gap there that you can't walk over. This orange filter playing on this map makes it very disorientating. But I'm managing. Thank goodness I'm not on the Cambrian Drift right now. I shouldn't have to go back there for too much more. Unless I want to get some other stuff, which I may at some point. But, you know, as cool as the Cambrian Drift is, I have to say it is the worst layout, I guess. It's so easy to get lost, especially when doing isolation vaults. Alright, mark that. And there's also a car in the background. So hopefully that's not too loud either. But if it is, I should be able to catch it and remove it. If I don't, yell at me in the comments. Alright. It is insanely easy to get lost in the Cambrian Drift things for a long time. Maybe I'm missing something, but you know, Warframe maps are not that great. And Warframe maps are not that great. The mini map and all of that, it works for a non-vertical layout. If it's all just one flat plane, it works well. But when you add layers, it doesn't work. It doesn't work at all. I think the best open world is Fortuna. Just for... I mean, the mission types and everything, from what I remember playing, I've had like the least issues in general with Fortuna. Everything else kinda sucks. And I lost my chance on getting the Octavia blueprint. 10% chance, and I didn't get it. So let's see if I have any of the Naja ones. So, starting with the blueprint, there is Mezo, C6, and D6. So, let's find a Mezo fissure. Sabotage, spy. Oh god, okay, sabotage, 5 minutes left. So, I have Mezo, C6, and D6. I have two C6. Do I have any D6? No. Alright, so I have two of these, and I think I'd want to increase this all the way to 100%, or to Radiant. I'm not entirely sure, but I think that's what I would want to do here. I want the blueprint, and yeah. I think I have, yeah, I have the prime stock for that. I don't know what I'm missing for the Corinth, but I'm missing like one thing. I'm missing one Guando blade. So it'd be cool if I could get one of those, so I can finish those weapons. But the Warframes are my priority. Why? I don't know. I just want them. I don't know. I want all of the prime frames that I can get. And just, I collect them, I guess. I try to collect all of the frames, but if I've already leveled it up, I think the one that I'm not gonna get again, I only keep the prime variants, but I'm not gonna bother getting Gaara again, because I'm just gonna wait for a prime variant. She's not the worst by any means, but the farming for her again is a bitch. It'd be cooler if once you farmed and built a warframe once, you could like put it in reserve, like kind of like the cryostasis that you can put dogs into, the Kubros and Kavats. If you could do that with warframes, so you know, I don't know. They wouldn't do that because that would cut into their platinum thing. But the one thing I'm adamant about that wouldn't cut their platinum, I guess, money-making thing that they really need to do is remove time gates. I don't care what anyone says. They wouldn't hurt for money if they did that. Because I've never once spent platinum to speed something up. Okay, maybe I did one time, but like, I bought platinum for another reason. And it was like 5 platinum to speed it up, and I was just extremely impatient. But I'd imagine most of their sales come from the skins and boosters. Which, you know, I don't understand the need to time gate everything. Like, I gotta say, the most satisfying part about the Railjacks, when you want to fabricate, like, a turret or a part for it, it's instantaneous. But it takes, like, how many days to get into Railjacks? All because they didn't want to wait until they were finished with it to release it. Man, I could go on and on about that, but I'm gonna stop because I know I annoy people when I rant. But man, I rant for a reason. Because things could be better. I think you need someone complaining. Not too much. There's a certain type of complaining that's not helpful. There's a lot of times you complain that aren't helpful, but I don't know. That's a whole can of worms right there that I'm not going to get into. I just said can of worms. That's funny, I play Nidus, but I never use his abilities. Mostly because I don't like having to power them up. If you have any tips for how to play Nidus, please let me know. Because I have him. I love Nidus, but it took me, like, having owned him for a year to figure out that my 4 adds to my count, whatever the fuck that counting meter is called. Like, I didn't know that the maggots and all of that added to it. I forgot exactly what it was, but they also add to it, which is perfect. And Naja Prime Blueprint, that's what I was after. Oh man, that's what I need right there too. Oh, screw Naja, I'm never going to play him. I have one more of these, maybe I'll get lucky again, but I can build the Corinth now. Which, the Corinth Prime is beautiful. I love the regular Corinth. Being able to have the Prime variant will make me very happy. Alright, let's leave this squad and go queue that up. Alright, Corinth. Corinth Prime, here we go. Cue that up. What other Prime? items am I close to making? I do want the Pandero and the, what is it called? The, starts with the T, I think. Octavius Primary. The Prime variant. Gondal Prime, I just need a blade. Cronin, I need a blade and a Prime handle. And I think I'm also close to the Panthera Prime, aren't I? No, not really. I need the barrel and the receiver. But I haven't really been going out of my way to farm those. But I'm glad I was able to get a piece. Alright, let's see. Mezzo. Only the spy missions. Really? Oh, skirmish. Alright, those are better. I'll do this one. Railjack mission. I'm gonna take the C6. I swear, if I get something... If there's another really high quality one when I'm farming this, that's gonna be so annoying. I mean, awesome, but annoying. I'd prefer it if I didn't have to, skip out on a part for another part. But hey, I don't want to have to go out of my way to farm a gold rare later on. Alright, was it... Okay, I don't think these were worth the investment. These take more skill to use than my last one. But they do destroy really quick. I think these, I don't remember what these are called, but... These guns, I got them in as a wreckage thing to repair or scrap. They're Mark III. That was like the first wreckage I got, so I decided to make them. Alright, I have to kill a bunch of these. I need to make dumbfire rockets. I had someone join my stream. And they are asking a pilot, and I understood why. As soon as they took control, and they started using the dumbfire rockets. I think they're dumbfire rockets. Correct me if I'm wrong, please. I don't understand Warframe that much. I've played for nearly 3,000 hours, and I still am very much a noob. Is the... Like... They took control of my railjack, and somehow used an ability that sent out a fuck ton of small missiles. I don't know how they did it. What do these do? Is it one of these buttons over here? Need more energy. Need more energy. I don't remember what these do down there. Out of service. Repair electrical malfunctions. The fuck? I don't know what's going on. I'm just shooting ships. I'm pressing buttons that I probably shouldn't. But it's kind of annoying that my railjack has energy. That I have to manage along with my Warframe's energy. And my... Arc Rings energy. Alright. I don't know what my my crew is set to do at the moment, but I don't think I have any real players here. I might get some in a minute, but judging by the fact that I haven't gotten any yet. Okay, these overheat way too quickly. I know they can, like, tap an enemy really quickly, but I am not a good enough shot for that. I'm very much not a good enough shot for that. That's a cruise ship. I need to look at like a guide on railjacks and all the different things you can do. Yeah, as soon as it's disabled, I'll get in the big gun. Yeah, and I'm gonna blap him. I'm gonna blap him real good. Enemies dropped a little bit more, maybe. Laying mines. Alright, where did all the enemies go? Well, a new group just spawned in. Just take the bullet. Just ran right into my rocket. Alright. That's a lot of fighters. I really need that missile swarm thing. I'm sure that's like invaluable. Assuming these ships have weak spots. I'm guessing that they on like the underbelly is a weak spot, but I don't know. Seems to act like it. Alright. Hopefully my computer fan isn't being heard or distorting my voice with the noise reduction option in OBS. I know that can be a thing. I think I'm set to public, right? I was just doing public missions. I don't think I set myself to private. Alright. So I think I need to make more energy at the forge, now that I think about it. Oh yeah, my ordnance isn't getting used up because of that one mod. And then right as I say that, it starts getting used up. Okay, it looks like its engines are out, which is exactly what I wanted. So it should be dead in the water. Oh, I need to make more. Shit. Alright, let's jump to the forge and repair electrical malfunctions. Alright, so I can't give anyone commands. Where is my Omni-Tool? Why is it down there? Why did my Omni-Tool move? Is that... no. Where's... there's electrical malfunctions over there. Oh my goodness. Oh, okay. That is really annoying. So now I can use this. So that one's set to a gunner, defender, oh no wonder, gunner, engineer. Alright. Let's go to the forge. Make more energy. Dome charges. Energy again, maybe. No, Revelite, I guess. And then I think that's good. And then I want to go to the bridge and pilot this thing again. Now all I need to do is go after the cruise ships. Alright, and it's two thrusters or boosters are down. Sorry if I made a loud whistle there. One thing I can do is slingshot myself into the cruise ships, which I think is one thing I'm gonna do. Yee. I love how you can just do that, that's so dumb. Perfect, that's what I wanted. I'm here for the reactant. Alright, there we go. I'm farming this up real good. God damn, that's just going. These now, so I don't have to worry about it later. Because if I have to worry about it later, then those fuckers will spawn on my ship and kill my crew while I'm inside, and it'll just, it ruins everything. Whoops. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Alright. You guys made me use up a bunch of my stuff. That's not fair. You guys made me ink. Come on. Fucking Finding Nemo. Alright, I think that's taken care of. I'm not getting all my stacks. I don't care. I'll get them later. Is this another cruise ship? Looks like it. Alright, come on. And I'm out of energy. Wonderful. Let's see if I can group everyone up again. Get some energy, and then there we go. Just keep tapping. Alright, this is ridiculous. Taken care of, and I think that's the last cruise ship. Judging judging by the 5 out of 6, this one should blow up and we should be alright. Hopefully. Yeah. Okay. And now I need to go here. Disable the pulse turbine. I think I might need a pilot. So let's take the one of the gunners here. Who's a better pilot? I don't know. You're gonna be the pilot for right now. Afraid that won't be possible. Okay, how about now? Alright. Afraid that can't. I'm your captain. You do as I say. Why isn't it letting me teleport? Weird. Usually can do that dash thing. Oh jeez. Good thing those nullifiers don't get rid of your stacks. I should be quiet. Don't want to give DE any ideas. Okay, so maybe this is how you're supposed to do it. And took care of those. And now, Railjack crew, destroy the first radiator. Please tell me the AI is capable of doing this. If the AI does not do it in a few seconds, I will assume that I have to do all the work, even though I hired a crew. Alright, so I have to do all the work here. Teleporting back. Okay, Gricata is down. Get back at that. Not about doing a Clinton Gricata ASMR video, but you know. I decided against it. Where the hell? What is this pilot doing? Where are we? Oh, there it is. Well, Jack, or destroy the first. Okay. Okay, I have to captain now. Look at me. I am the captain now. There we are. I don't know what's so hard about shooting the big red thing. Alright, okay, stop captaining. You can't fucking do it right. Or piloting, I should say. Is he? He's piloting again. Get off the pilot seat, you fucking delinquent. To go do this, expose the next generator, hopefully I don't have to come back out or come back in again, which I think I might have to. Railjack crew has to do that. And teleport back in. Please tell me I don't have to go back in after this. Away crew, fucking hell. In and out, in and out. Not like that, you perv. I'm used to... God damn it. I'm used to Viper always fucking... making every little thing. An innuendo, like that. You'd giggle at that, wouldn't you, Viper? I don't know if you watch my videos, I don't think you do, but... I wouldn't be surprised. I returned to rail, Jack. Remember when they said that you could hack from your, the epitaph blueprint? Oh, this game. This fucking game. I spent 2 days trying to get that. Alright, whatever. Okay. I don't even remember what I was saying. But I do know that I ended up slightly screwing myself. But at the same time, you know, I'm not too far away from getting Naja Prime. But I am now guaranteed Corinth Prime. So it wasn't the worst, you know, outcome. But you can tell me, did I mess up there? Was Naja the better option? Probably not. Yeah. Alright. So that is where I'm gonna end this, because I have been streaming as well, but I've been recording for too long. I've been awake for too long. So thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye-bye.